Hi, this is Leah Mudkus-Peterson, the chairwoman of the Arizona Corporation Commission. This is my chairwoman's chat, short video that I shoot right after our open meetings to explain to the public exactly the work that we've been doing over the last 48 hours or so during our recent open meeting. If you're not familiar with the Arizona Corporation Commission, we regulate the utility industry. So that includes electric, water, gas, and wastewater. We manage railroad and pipeline safety. We incorporate all the businesses in the state, and then we protect Arizonans against security fraud. So there's a lot of different items that are on our agenda. I wanted to highlight just a few of them. The last couple days, we have really been focused on a very important issue, which is protecting Arizonans during extreme heat and cold in the state of Arizona, during times when they may be challenged in paying their bills and the utilities are disconnecting. We had set some rules in place prior to the pandemic and even prior to that are calendar-based, June 1st through October 15th, and that is a time in which Arizonans cannot be disconnected during this time and can work out payment plans with the utilities. But we needed permanent rules moving forward. So yesterday we voted on a package of permanent rules that'll move into formal rulemaking. I took some notes to make sure that I was including for you some of those details as they might be interesting to you. First off, these rules that we did put in place were after 2 years of different workshops with stakeholders and the public, giving us their perspective on how the rules should be created as related to our utilities that we regulate in the state. And obviously with the priority being how to protect Arizona families who are facing these financial difficulties. We included new reporting requirements. We also talked about how best to communicate with customers who are delinquent and how to use technology to do so. We raised the threshold in which disconnection would occur for electricity customers to $300 and for gas customers to $100. The temperature threshold under which utilities cannot disconnect, we set at 95 degrees after a lot of debate and discussion. And we also put together programs and discussed support for programs to assist vulnerable populations with heat-related safety concerns. Obviously, the priority of all the commissioners is to ensure we don't have heat-related deaths and illnesses related to disconnection from their utility company. And we want to do all we can to protect Arizona. And again, I wanted to mention that it will take several months for our formal rulemaking to occur. So during that time, our current moratorium will stay in place. And again, that's June 1st through October 15th. Customers won't be disconnected for non-payment and can work out payment plans with the utilities during that time. In addition, on this agenda, wanted to highlight a couple other items, though we had a whole lot of items on this one. We talked about and approved APS's application to allow for increased deployment of solar projects in low-income multifamily housing. So very interesting debate and projects planned there. We also approved a detailed timeline for APS in their aggregation tariff. And this allows the aggregation of demand side resources, which are like smart thermostats, connected hot water heaters, energy storage systems. And this will really assist Arizona consumers who are interested in adopting these new technologies. So very proud to support those efforts also. Of course, you can watch our entire meeting, again, which occurred over a two-day period at azcc.gov, and you can hear the debate and discussion that occurred around these items as well as many of the others. Of course, we would really appreciate your communication and input on these issues as well as things coming up in the future. You can reach any of your commissioners that are, again, elected statewide, so representing everyone in the state, at azcc.gov. That's azcc.gov. And thanks again for your interest in the Arizona Corporation Commission.